out of here.
Next adventure is down in the Victorian High Country, and we're actually up on Mount Sterling at the moment, one of the ski resort areas, and Mount Hotham's just over the other side there. And we are with our four-wheel drive family, our dear friends from the four-wheel drive club, or one of the clubs in Sydney, a small club. So there's only a few of us on this trip, but so you will see some of our friends in this video. And we're just getting the cars ready for our first section of four-wheel drive track. But yes, 5 days on this adventure. And straight off the bat, we're going to be seeing Craig's hut for the Man for Snow River. I've always wanted to see that. As I've mentioned before, come from a farming background, and they do originate in the New South Wales snowy mountains. So some of my forefathers and all family and grandparents and great-grandparents and further back. So yeah, it's really looking forward to seeing this this hut. It's been something in mind I've wanted to do for a long time. But anyway, we're in a beautiful part of Victoria on this adventure. Yes. Come here, Jason. This is one of my mates, Jason. He was our ring bearer at the wedding, weren't you? Yes. You had a good time.
Yep.
You sure did, and he was very well behaved, because you'll soon discover what a mischief Jason is. He's very cheeky in a good way. But he was a good boy at the wedding. Yes. Right, let's have a look in here. Oh, the smell's really, it smells really good, doesn't it?
Yep.
It's beautiful. It's just that smell of timber and fireplaces. It's just irreplaceable. When you've smelled it, you know it's beautiful. for splitting the tyres down so that there's more grip on the road. So Susie's all growed up. We've got the roof rack on. Shane's done a really terrific job. I'll show you a bit later inside the boot of the car. He's done some great modifications and also what he's done in the front on the dash. Susie's no longer just a little family car for day four driving. She's doing the serious stuff now. And Shane's put the snorkel on and he's put some stronger suspension on and raised her up a bit. So we've got a bit more ground clearance and we've got recovery points. You can just see those little red dots at the front of the car. That's the new recovery points. So yes, hopefully we won't need any of that, but it's there if we need it. just can't explain the feeling of finally seeing this hut. It's magical. It's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen up in the high country. I absolutely love these huts, and this has always been my favorite. Unfortunately, it is a very popular place, but look, it is a spectacular place to visit. And the backdrop behind me, it's just breathtaking. What a privilege to be here. A nasty section here, and somebody's had a bit of trouble getting up, so we're just going to give them the winch to get out so we can get down.
Maybe it's going around the top.
That's it.
I still don't trust those things.
Straight up here.
interesting little venture, a bit of interesting something different. So got the car sorted, and Shane's just moved up into lead position, so we got the other three cars behind us. So we're going to go down and have a look at Bindery Falls. I think it's only about 5 kilometres down the road, so see what that looks like.
This is the lovely Bindery Falls. Not bad if I do say so myself. Let's go down and have a bit more of a closer look.
Oh
my gosh.
All different mosses and ferns and undercut rocks.
It is, it's like a
bonsai.
Yeah. It was like a magical garden.
Diorama.
Yeah. Look
at this. Amazing.
Even up here in the roof. We've just found our campsite for this afternoon. Don't ask me what it's called because I don't know, but we are close to a nice little river. And we're just going to go check it out before we set up for the afternoon. I don't know if it's all blackberries, fancies. Oh yeah, my. Maybe fishing. We've still got some worms on the way. This lovely little river. Yeah, we might. I haven't seen any fish in here, but that's not to say there's not. It's very pretty though. I don't mind even just bringing happy hour down here sometime. Find a rock to sit on and soak my feet. Decided they're going further down here, right down the end of the campground. So I said, oh, I'd walk. It's nice. I really like this spot. It's beautiful. I don't know how I always use that word, but what else can you say when it's beautiful? I can handle this. What I absolutely love, we just passed a, so a lot of this is actually state forest intermingled with national parks in the High Country, and there's I've always had horses, I just haven't had them for the last 4 or 5 years, but you can bring your horses down here and they've got yards and water, and you can ride right up to Craig's Hut. I can't believe that. Anyway, this is our spot. Good morning. We're just about to start another day. We're at the Bidibinji campground, I think it's called, just down from the falls that we visited yesterday. It's a really lovely morning. As you can see, we've got full sunshine and a beautiful running brook right past. We're apparently going to be having a quiet day today, a rest day, so I've thankfully bought a book. I'm going to enjoy reading and just doing some very chilled activities today. Oh, we're just heading off down the creek here, about 600 metres I think Shane said. I'm going to do a bit of fishing and explore the creek, and hopefully we'll catch some fish. Shane's caught a couple last night and this morning. So, yeah, it should be a good lunch. We're going to have them on nice wraps. Have some nice wraps for lunch with fish if we catch any. But anyway, I'm getting left behind, so I'll keep going. Yeah, good casting. Ha ha.
Keep going down, so you don't stop for me.
You're snagged.
Get up a little. These trees are amazing. Look at all the bark coming off these trees.
Up this section, but down lower it looks nice.
Right, so we've just made it down to the junction of the Hakwa River, which is the one over on that side, and then Bindari Creek, and they all flow into one. So yeah, very pretty. Don't recommend going up Bindari Creek, very slippery. I've already got a minor injury, just a stab in the leg from a bit of timber under the water, but the things you do when you go out exploring. But yes, I think we've just come to the end of the line for today's little adventure, and we're just going to head back shortly. But there'll be more fishing. Yeah, the fish are definitely, the trout here are taking the worms. They're not too fazed on the lures, which is usually the case. Where would you go with Kentucky Fried Chicken if you're going to have a banquet of rump steak and veg? Chains on! We're just sitting here having a chat after our walk down the river this morning, and yes, poor Jay got a leech, and Shane asked him where he got it. Where did you say you got
it? My village!
It was near the nether regions.
Oh shit, Chris.
Very good. You're a natural little adventurer. You've been initiated once you've got a leech on you. Good morning.
Howdy.
Howdy. Here we are on day three of our four drive trip, and we've just started a place called Bluff Hut. And it's huge in here. I'll take you back out and have a look. I'm just trying to get out of the way. The others are trying to take photos. Have a look at that. That's the biggest fireplace I've seen in any hut. And it's just bench top. The back door. Just coming to look out here at Bluff Hut. Bluff's Hut. It's supposed to be a very nice view. What did you say? I was looking across to Mount Buller.
Wow.
Oh, this is very pretty. Oh, you can camp up here. Imagine camping up here. This is Steve, by the way. I haven't introduced Steve. Jason! Oh. Get back down to the cars. This is easy going for us. We're spoiled driving cars around.
Well,
Normally we walk. I've got to get some photos over here. There's some beautiful flowers. I love my flowers. So that's called the Bluff. That's where they feature in the Man from Snow River, and he's riding his horse up the bluff there to the top. So I'll have to go back and revisit the movie now to see. Arrived at another hut for the day, or today. This one's called Lovick's Hut, and I think it's probably the biggest we've seen so far. It's huge. I'm loving these massive stone paved floors. It's huge. It is very popular with trail riders camping up here, so yeah, you can see beautiful big red benches. We have a very interesting situation here. You cannot even describe how deep this is down there. I think the really sensible only way is up around the top here. Yeah. We ain't going down there. Right, I think we're onto our last hut for the day. This one's called Kelly Hut, and I think this would have to be my favourite as far as the views go. We've got a wonderful big plain that goes right down the valley here. They're pretty rough in here, like dirt floors, whereas a lot of the ones up in Kosciuszko have got timber floors. But they're very basic, these huts, but there's one thing that they all have is a huge fireplace. Good morning. It's going to be a quick one this morning. We have a very fresh morning, as to be expected, and it's going to be a lovely day. Just going to kick back with a coffee and some breakfast and just soak in this gorgeous valley. And then apparently
goat track, which probably is very name-worthy. It's, we've been told it's very up and down and very steep and a bit slippery, so I think we're in for some good adventure today. I'm not doing any of the driving. I think I'll be happily filming behind the camera today and let the expert do all the driving today.
Expert, really?
The one that knows better than I. So let's see what's ahead. It's going to be a good day, I think. We're going for it's only a half a K walk in to Mukara Hut. We've just come down off Mount Wellington. Jay's, Shane's and my adopted son, aren't you? Yep. Adopted son, surrogate son, foster nephew. Our little shadow.
Oh, some gloves.
Well, I keep saying I love every cottage or every hut, and I do, but I think it's more the location. It's very simple inside. Some of them are being more grand, but this one is, I just love this location. Oh, it's a picture postcard. That's what it is. It's a picture postcard. Nah, this, to date, or so far, this is my favourite. Belongs on a postcard.
Hell.
I was just saying, this is a really lovely little creek. It's almost like a little fairy tale creek. There should be little pixies and fairies and all sorts of, like Lord of the Rings village. It's just beautiful. And it winds around here and then goes back over the back there, and there's little ferns. Wow. Someone's being a rat bag. Quite a popular little four-wheel drive spot here. There's cars everywhere.
Just arrived at the Pinnacle Lookout. I'm going to go up here and have a little look. Then we'll have some lunch.
That would have to be Jay. Yes. Just heading off up the Billy Goat track, or was it Billy Goat Bluff? Billy Goat Bluff track, there we go. So we just started off, but yeah, I'm looking forward to this, I think. It's already getting rugged and we haven't even hit the best part.
Down.
happened then is when we hit the ground, it cracked the sidewall of the tyre.
Got pinched.
So yeah, we're trying to get down to a flat spot as quickly as we can safely. This is... Oh.
As you're coming down, you're probably about 100 metres away from the landing here.
Yeah. Oh, that's it. We've just got to get 100 more metres and then we're safe. I can hear it blowing out still. Ah, oh, nothing like a little bit of high stress levels. Right, we made it down. Oh. Do you want us to come up where you are, Steve? We're on the flat here.
Further down, there's a big area here.
Righto, we'll keep coming. Rolling down. Oh my god, we just made that. That was so close.
We'll see how we go with this.
All right, well, we've got a change of tyre. Downside is it's not an all terrain tyre, it's just a normal on-road tyre. So we're going to be a bit more of a disadvantage now. Shane said the last time I got out, I jinxed him, so we don't want another flat tyre. We cannot afford another flat tyre. Three times goes the sidestep. I can't hear it dragging. Well, that's the finale of our holiday or our four-wheel drive trip. Off go the... There's a queue to go up the mountain now. But that's the finale for us. Anyway, I think we're off to the pub for a beer. Well, we're in Dargo at the Dargo pub. And it is just four-wheel drive Grand Central. There's four-wheel drives everywhere. Time to go get a beer.
It's a great trip, boys. We'll catch you on the next one, okay? Over.
Okay, thanks for that, mate. And have a good one. Keep the sunny side up and the greasy side down. Catch you next time.
Copy that. Over and out. Bye.
that's a wrap, and thanks for watching.
What a sight. I said, what a sight. Didn't waste any time. You wet your pants. The junction here of the Hakwa River. I've got a cheeky little monster just where is he? Mozzie. Come this way. Thanks. Whoa, slippery. You're going that way, are you? He's a smart boy. I think you're right, this is just a more sensible way. Sometimes I think us adults overthink things too much.
Someone's tea.
It's a nice little creek here by the hut. I got you. He's trying to distract me. Gotcha. Feel better?